And at the time of this earthquake, there were many people actually involved in earthquake drills because today, as you may have referenced, is the anniversary, the 32nd anniversary of one of the worst earthquakes to ever hit Mexico. It was in Mexico City. That earthquake was 8.0 on the Richter scale, but it killed upwards of 5,000. Some estimates say as many as 20,000 people. This one, as you said, about 73 miles south of Mexico City proper, but it was about 34 miles deep, a very deep earthquake. Meaning the effects are felt much further away. Remember the rule, shallow earthquakes, the destruction is vast where it hits. Deep earthquakes, the destruction is kind of spread out because the waves reverberate. It should be noted that Mexico City has 20 million people in the greater Mexico City area. It is one of the biggest cities in the world, and the reason that it is so susceptible to big-time damage and earthquakes is because most of the city was built on a lake bed, meaning that they have this thing called liquefaction. So when you have these earthquakes, the ground literally just turns to water and the buildings kind of crumple in. Not all of Mexico City is built on a lake bed, but those parts that are, you can imagine the damage that is in those areas. The initial pictures we're seeing now are from pretty close to downtown Mexico City. The surrounding areas are probably going to take a little longer to get to, but it's the surrounding areas where the poor people are. And if you've been to Mexico City, you realize there are very much two classes of people, the rich and the poor. And the poor, even though the earthquake standards and structures have come a long way in those 32 years, they're still in very dilapidated buildings. So you would expect the damage in the outlying areas to be much more severe than in the downtown areas.
Hey, everybody, Tim Ralston here. You know, the video you just watched, that's real life. Real life can happen to you at any moment. We can't choose a time and place of an emergency, but what we can choose is whether we're prepared for it or not. I'd like for you to tune in to timralstonlive.com/training, where I can give you access to a great training videos that might give you that edge in case you're faced with one of those emergencies.